Welcome to this video celebrating Black Lives and Black Brilliance in Brent. By learning about your own and other people's heritage, including music, beliefs, food and art, we can enjoy all the different experiences and ideas that there are in Brent and the wider world. There is so much to find out. We all have our contributions to make and to celebrate. So when we say Black History, what do you think we mean? Well, Black History is the experiences of people of African and African Caribbean heritage in the past. Can you see where the continent of Africa is on this map? And on this map, can you see where the Caribbean is? The Caribbean is the Caribbean Sea, the islands there, and the coasts near it. It's east of Central America. So we live in Brent. Brent is an area of London. It's one of the boroughs in northwest London. Can you see it coloured in red on this map? Brent Museum and Archives look after lots of old special paper objects. They include things like diaries and lists of things that happened at churches in Brent. Nearly 300 years ago, there was a little girl, and her name was Sarah Echo, and she was christened at St Mary's Church in Willesden. And we know this because there was a written record of her christening in the church records. Here we have a photograph of some of the writing that was done in that book. Can you see her name about halfway down? It says C, that's for christening, and then Sarah, daughter of Tobias Echo, a Black. And the date is 15th of September, 1723. In the Christian church, christening is the time when you're given your first name, and baptism is a special ceremony when you join the Christian church. It normally happens when you're a baby. This is the earliest record of a Black person living in Brent. From other records at the church, we know that she had younger brothers called Tobias, John, Edward and William, although really sadly, William died before he grew up. We don't know when Sarah's parents arrived in Willesden or where they came from. We can also look at photographs to learn about Black history in Brent. This group photograph was taken outside a building at Neasden Stud Farm. A stud farm is a place where horses are bred. And we think it's from the 1890s, so this photograph is about 130 years old. It's the oldest known photograph of a Black person in Brent. Unfortunately, we don't know the names of anybody in the photograph, but we can look at the photo and we can have our ideas about how we think they were connected. What do you think? This photograph was taken in Kilburn in the 1950s or 60s, so about 60 or 70 years ago. These people would be about 65 or 75 years old now. We don't know their names, we just have this photograph. What do you think they're doing? I'm reading Mary Seacole's book about her experiences called Wonderful Adventures of Mrs. Seacole in Many Lands that she wrote in 1857 when she was 52 years old. She's such a good writer. It feels as though I'm in the same room as her, hearing her speak when I read the book. She loved travelling and helping people and using her medical skills. You might know already that she was born in Jamaica and that she faced unfairness and discrimination as a Black woman when she tried to volunteer as a nurse during the Crimean War. When the British turned down her offer of help, she decided to go to the Crimea by herself. She set up a British hotel near the front line to provide comfort and supplies to the army. She rode nearly every day to the battlefront to give out medicines and nurse the injured and dying. She was really well known when she returned to England. In 2004, she was voted number one in a poll of Great Black Britons. And when she died in 1881, she was buried at Kensal Green Cemetery in Brent. This is a photograph of her grave. The Reverend Norman Watson Mitchell, MBE, arrived in Britain in 1955 when he was 35 years old. In 1980, Mr. Mitchell set up the West Indian Senior Citizens Organisation. He was concerned that people were lonely and he wanted to give them an opportunity to come together and do some social activities. He was thinking about the older members of the Caribbean community. in 2014, he got an award, the Member of the Order of the British Empire, or MBE for short. And that's an award that people get for making a really positive impact in their line of work or as recognition for community work and service. Alison Williams MBE arrived in Britain in 1969 when she was 21 years old. She flew to Britain from Trinidad to train to be a nurse. In 2002, Alison Williams was given an MBE for her outstanding contribution to the development of midwifery services in London. Midwives help women give birth as safely and easily as possible. Cyril Regis MBE. Now, he was one of the first black footballers in England. He was born in 1958 in Maripasoula in French Guiana. He moved to Queen's Park when he was 8 and lived in Brent until he was 19. He used to play football at the Welsh Harp. He used to go to Wembley Market and he played in cup finals at Wembley Stadium. He went to school at Kensal Rise Primary School and he also went to Cardinal Hinsey High School. He played as a forward. His professional playing career spanned 19 years and he made 614 league appearances and scored 158 league goals. Cyril Regis also won 5 caps with the England national team. He overcame a huge amount of racism and he's inspired so many young black players. This is a photograph of Rhoda Ibrahim. She runs the Somali Advice and Forum of Information community group in Brent. Her studies brought her to London, but then the war in Somalia stopped her being able to go back. She worked with the United Nations and community groups to help Somali people in lots of different countries in Africa and Yemen until around 2002. And then she started working with Somalis in Brent and helping us to learn more about traditional Somali crafts and culture. She really inspires me because she's always so keen to help and she's so generous with her time. This year, we saw people coming together across the world to protest injustice towards people of black heritage as part of the Black Lives Matter campaign following the death of George Floyd at the hands of a Minneapolis police officer. Brent council leaders and community leaders came together to show their solidarity with the campaign. The Civic Centre was lit up with purple lights and the council's leader, deputy leader and chief executive met with leaders and young people from black communities across Brent to listen to their concerns and ideas about what could be done to make lives better for local residents. They've agreed a plan to support the black community. You can visit Brent Museum and Archives at the library at Willesden Green and find out more about Brent's history, including where Bob Marley lived in Neasden in 1972. On our website, there are lots of information sheets about Brent's past, including one about Arthur Wint. He was the Jamaican team captain at the 1948 Olympics at Wembley. He was an amazing person. He wasn't only an athlete, he was also a pilot, a doctor, and a diplomat. He won Jamaica's first Olympic gold medal for the 400 metres. Below this video on YouTube, there's a link to a learning resource pack with photographs, information and useful links, including a link to interviews with Windrush Generation elders that was carried out in 2020. Can I suggest that you now follow the first link under this video on YouTube, which shows the moment in 2016 that St Michael and All Angels Still Orchestra from Brent won Best Band on the Road category at Notting Hill Carnival with I Will Survive.